You wake up in a dark, dripping cave. The air feels thick, syrupy, and sweet, like it's alive. Each breath fills your chest with something heavy, almost electric. You push away the stone covering the entrance, and light floods in. A rush of humid heat hits your face. Outside, the world glows green. Ferns tower like skyscrapers. Mushrooms rise like ancient pillars. Even the ground breathes, soft moss releasing clouds of steam with every step. Then you hear it, a sound too deep to be a fly, too steady to be thunder. A low hum that vibrates through the jungle, not wind, wings. Welcome to the Carboniferous period, 300 million years ago. A time before mammals, before dinosaurs, when oxygen ruled the air and insects ruled the earth. The air here holds 35% oxygen, almost double what you breathe today. It tastes rich, sharp, intoxicating. You feel awake, powerful, like your lungs are supercharged. But that same oxygen could kill you. Too much of it burns your lungs, floods your blood, and tricks your brain into euphoria. Stay here long enough, and you'd pass out before anything even touches you. Above the trees, something glides. A meganeura, a dragonfly the size of a hawk. Its wings stretch nearly 3 feet across. Its compound eyes, each the size of a coin, shimmer like bronze. It hunts frogs, reptiles, even other dragonflies. When it dives, the air itself screams. You push deeper into the forest. Every step cracks shells instead of twigs, fragments of shed exoskeletons from insects bigger than your hand. The air smells of damp plants, decay, and ozone. You stop. Something stirs beside you. Sliding between the ferns is an arthropleura, the largest land invertebrate in Earth's history. 8 feet long, 100 pounds, 30 armored segments ripple as hundreds of legs glide beneath its body. Once thought to be a predator, it's actually an herbivore, one of the planet's first true grazers. Still, a single defensive snap from its jaws could open your arm like paper. It ignores you and keeps moving, but then it freezes. So does everything else. The forest holds its breath. Even the air seems to pause. Then you hear it, the sound that even giants fear. Wings, massive wings. You dive for cover as the meganeura dives again. A glass-winged missile of muscle and hunger. It strikes the ground, missing you by inches. Its wings churn the air like helicopter blades. You roll behind a tree, heart pounding. The ground shakes. Something else moves. A pulmonoscorpius, the largest scorpion that ever lived, nearly a meter long. Armored in thick chitin, its stinger raised like a drawn sword. It prowls the swamp with surprising grace, its glowing venom lighting the mud beneath it. Two central eyes focus on you. Smaller eyes shimmer along its back, catching every flicker of light. You don't breathe. If you move, you're done. You wait until it vanishes into the ferns, and then step backward into a web, thick, rope-like, sticky. You turn slowly. A shape crouches above the pond. Megarachne, once mistaken for a spider, but actually a sea scorpion. Its body almost 2 feet long, armored and flat. Paddle-like limbs scrape through the mud, sifting for prey. Its round eyes flash with cold light. It doesn't move toward you. Yet. Overhead, the sky hums again. Hundreds of dragonflies circle like vultures. Their wings shimmer silver and gold in the dim sun. Each one big enough to take a bird. You take one step, and the ground sings beneath you. A vibration through roots, webs, and hollow logs. In this world, every step tells something you're alive. You run, through ferns, through fog, through heat. The air itself feels heavy. You stop only when your lungs burn. And then remember, in air this rich, even breathing can betray you. Hyperoxia. Too much oxygen saturates your blood. Your hands shake. Your vision blurs. You feel drunk on air. You try to make a fire, but the tiniest spark erupts into a blaze. With oxygen this high, even wet wood burns like gasoline. That's why wildfires rage here constantly. A single lightning strike can turn an entire forest into an inferno. But that same forest is why the air is so thick. Trees here haven't evolved to decay. When they fall, they don't rot. They stack. Millions of years later, they'll become coal. That's why almost all the world's coal comes from this age, a planet burning and preserving itself at the same time. The sun dips behind the trees. Night falls fast. You stumble back toward your cave. Rain crashes down in sheets, extinguishing the fires. Steam rises from the forest floor like smoke from a dying world. Inside, it's quiet. Too quiet. Until you hear scraping, something moving across the wall, eight legs, eyes glinting like shards of glass, a trigonotarbid, one of Earth's first true land arachnids, armored like a knight, silent as the dark. It pauses inches from your hand, then slowly retreats into a crack in the stone. Outside, the jungle comes alive again, clicks, buzzes, hisses, every sound like clockwork from a different world. The forest breathes in rhythm, alive, aware, waiting. This was the Carboniferous, a time when life pushed the limits of what was possible. Oxygen fed everything, plants grew without bounds, and insects, free of predators, became kings of the planet. But balance never lasts. Over millions of years, something shifted. The great swamp forests began to dry. Rain fell less often, the air thinned, oxygen dropped, and when the forests fell, so did their giants. With them came something new, the first reptiles. Tiny, scaled, and air-breathing, their amniotic eggs could survive away from water. While insects and amphibians gasped for breath, these creatures thrived. The world was changing, from the age of insects to the age of reptiles. You wake again. The storm has passed. Mist drifts through the trees. Everything feels still, almost peaceful. For a moment, it's easy to forget where and when you are. Then the hum returns, low, deep, endless. Wings flicker through the fog. You see a shadow sweep past the light, and you realize the truth. In this world, you are the intruder, a fragile visitor in a land built for monsters. The age of giant insects was real. And if you had lived here, you wouldn't have lasted a single day. If ancient worlds like this fascinate you as much as they do me, make sure you're subscribed to Loop Through Time. Every week we travel further into Earth's forgotten ages, from oceans of living armor to skies filled with creatures beyond imagination. Next episode, we'll uncover the rise of the first reptiles that inherited this burning, oxygen-soaked planet, and how they shaped the next great empire of life on Earth. Until then, stay curious and keep exploring the past.